Topic for today's video is Huygens-Fresnel theory of diffraction, and the contents are as follows. So first we'll start with Huygens principle for wave propagation, inadequacies related to Huygens principle, Fresnel's addition to the original idea, and then finally Huygens-Fresnel principle, which is the backbone of theory for diffraction of light, and then Fresnel's assumption. Huygens principle states that every point on a given wavefront may be regarded as a source of a new disturbance called as secondary wavelets.
Let us consider a point source of light for which wavefront is spherical. If we go to a very large, practically infinite distance from the source, and we take only a small portion of that wavefront, that can be treated as a planar wavefront. Now, according to Huygens principle, every point on a given wavefront may be regarded as a source. So, if I take a point on the wavefront, it can be regarded as a source for secondary wavelet. We can take such n number of sources. This helps us in deciding the new position of wavefront. If this is at time t equals t1, we can decide what will be the wavefront at t1 plus, let's say, delta t.
These secondary wavelets, spherical in shape, will spread out in all directions from each point with the speed of light, as we have drawn in this figure. The envelope of these wavelets in the forward direction at any instant constitutes the new wavefront at that instant.
What do we mean by wavefront? Wavefront is defined as a surface on which the phase of disturbance is same at any given instant of time. All the points on the wavefront are in the same state of vibration. Now, according to Huygens postulate, envelope of these wavelets in forward direction will give us position of new wavefront. So we have to join all these tangential points on the secondary wavelets. Right now I have drawn only three points, but there is no limit to it. We can take very large number of points on this wavefront, and thus the envelope in the forward direction will give us the new position of wavefront.
Similar to planar wavefront, if we have a point source which we are observing at a short distance, spherical wavefront will also go out in all possible direction. New position of wavefront at later time can be decided by envelope of these blue secondary wavelets. Huygens principle could successfully explain the idea of reflection and refraction. But when it came to diffraction of light, there were few problems. Let us take example of a source which is passing through a narrow slit, and now apply Huygens principle to it. According to Huygens principle, the new position of wavefront will be given by secondary wavelets envelope. And as the time progresses, wavefront will keep on moving forward, and when reaches the screen, on the screen it will give a constant area of illumination with a strong boundary between geometric shadow and illuminated portion. On the screen, red is denoting that illuminated area of constant intensity, and above and below the slit is the region of geometric shadow. But in practice, what we get is the diffraction pattern due to a single slit. And also, in the region of geometric shadow, we see some light entering into it because of the bending of light. The two main problems with Huygens' assumptions were as follows. First, disregard to the overlap of waves in the region of geometric shadow. This happened because Huygens assumed that the amplitude or intensity is only there at the tangential point and nowhere else. The second one was that he ignored the wavefront formed by backward traveling waves. If we consider that a source is spherical and giving out radiation in all possible direction, but while considering construction of wavefront took into account only the forward moving waves, he completely ignored the wavefront which was going backward. So a large part of wavefront was ignored. Later, Fresnel took into account the superposition of these wavelets, and the mathematics involved with the Huygens-Fresnel principle was carried out by Kirchhoff's, which is also called as Fresnel-Kirchhoff's integral. These secondary wavelets interfere to give the diffraction pattern on the screen. Thus, with these additions by Fresnel, Huygens-Fresnel theory was successful in explaining the diffraction of light. With Fresnel's idea of including superposition of secondary wavelets, Huygens' principle states that every unobstructed point on a wavefront at a given instant serves as a secondary source of wavelet, and the amplitude of optical field at any point beyond is the superposition of all these waves. So as you can see, the first two lines are from Huygens' principle and the last two are Fresnel's addition to it. This principle is equally applied to Fresnel as well as Fraunhofer's class. Because of the planar wavefront in Fraunhofer's class, this can be ignored, but it becomes very important in Fresnel's class because the wavefront are always non-planar, that is either spherical or cylindrical. So that is all about Huygens-Fresnel principle. In the next video, we will talk in detail about Fresnel's assumptions and Fresnel's theory of half-period zones. Thank you.